And there it is. Here it comes. No, it's not. Yes, it is. It's what?
Happy Monday, children of the lawn.
It's Happy Monday, children of the lawn. Oh. Larry McGowan, Moog solo. Yeah. This is Electric Lady. It's funny because I'm listening to this and I was... Oh, it's... There's the stories.
Well, this is show and tell.
Yeah, I know. But I'm listening just because it's... I mean, Larry, you know, Larry, to my mind... Mark finished the sound of that band, but Larry certainly defined the sculpture of that band. And let me turn that band down a little bit. And it was super rock. Anyway, it was a lot of fun too. And I thought I'd try something a little different tonight for Rat Race Monday. I mean. And I should, do I need to qualify that this is, what was it, 67 to 97?
What is?
Or 68 to 98, my, you know, the stuff that I'm playing.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
All right.
Anyway. We're qualifying anything.
We're not qualifying anything. Speaking of qualifying, who watched IndyCar this weekend?
I did.
I know you did. Will Power.
Will Power.
William Stephen Power from Toowoomba, Queensland, Australia. Broke Mario Andretti's pole record.
41 years old.
41 years old.
Yep.
68 poles. That's a lot of dancing.
And he won the championship.
And he won the world championship.
He's
my favorite IndyCar driver. Laurie used to call him Darth Vader.
Yep, because I couldn't stand him.
Won the Indianapolis 500. And his brother is a comedian who is funny as hell.
Yes,
I digress. You'd have to know who he was to get half the humor.
Oh, and what about the good movie we saw over the weekend?
Oh, well, you know, it's interesting because this... We, you know, we got that old... Hey, you got HBO free for 89 minutes.
So we looked, actually a couple days.
Look for things that were 89 minutes long.
Well, we knew not to look for series, so we looked for movies.
No, so we look, and if you, I don't know if you've seen trailers for it, and you know, I mean, we're certainly your guide to
We're Siskel visual and Ebert. Entertainment. Come on, people.
Yeah, Siskel and Ebert. We're more like Sistic and Fiebert.
Well, a lot of people call us Gracie and...
Gracie, George and Gracie?
Yeah, George and Gracie.
Okay, and those people, I know how old those people are.
Well, it's usually Frank Feeney.
Oh, well, that makes all the sense in the world.
Right.
But yes, we watched Elvis.
The movie.
It's direct, so you know, if you care to watch it, that you're watching the right one. It's directed by Baz Luhrmann, who also... directed Moulin Rouge,
yeah.
Which is...
one of my favorites.
Hmm. I gave her the DVD once.
I still have it. Yes.
Yeah, you just don't have a DVD player. We do.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah,
when
here.
The power, like, when we lose the cable.
Yeah, see, we can get off the grid, right?
Season.
If the power goes out, we got the generator, which mm-hmm. keeps the refrigerator going, mm-hmm. powers the television.
And if the cable goes out... Because
if the cable goes out, then we just add the DVD player.
Man, the last hurricane we had 5 years ago, we had no cable or internet for like 3 weeks.
It was brutal.
I
felt
no
like,
you
know,
for
like...
9 days.
What?
We had no electricity for nine
yeah,
days.
Yeah, no electricity for 9 days. That's entertainment. But then you get the power back, and there's no internet.
Or cable.
So anyway, listen, it's, you know, listen, you want to hear somebody's sob story, don't listen to ours. Those poor people out west and all the, you know, but we're not going there. We just keep a good thought for them and we move on. But Elvis, man,
yeah.
I got to tell you what, it was
a great movie.
It was so, it was shocking, actually, when I, because, you know, that's Elvis is the ultimate, you know, entertainer, rock star, whatever you want to call it. You know, he was from before, Elvis was already there when I came into music. So, you know, to some people, that's like them being born after the Beatles. And so my taste in music was formed, you know, early, late 50s, early 60s. But this movie, and I knew about Tom Parker being a prick and the whatever.
Colonel Parker.
Yeah, Colonel Tom Parker. But this movie just put it so in your face that, you know, when it finally all comes together at the end, and I mean, it's not like you don't know how it ends, because you do. It's what happened to this beautiful kid? I mean, this was a kid who all the right things were happening at all the right times. I think the movie gets it pretty right.
Well, they said Priscilla.
Because she looked good in it.
But she said it was very accurate.
Yeah, she said it. And look, you know, the truth of the matter is, if you've seen everybody's story or heard, remember when the Memphis Mafia was out doing the talk shows and all that, it's if you piece it all together and you watch this film, you really come to some pretty staggering conclusions. And one of them is, be careful what you wish for.
Yeah, and he died at 42. He seemed so much older.
And we're watching this movie for over 2 hours, and he goes through all these changes and all this stuff happens, and it says that at the end, and when it was like 42.
Has sold more records than anybody ever to date.
So you gotta feel good about that. And what else? Okay, so Rat Race Day. I have an interesting one for you tonight. An interesting scenario for you.
Yes.
I don't know how this is gonna work.
Jack Hotop's watching.
Have heard something about yourself. He wants to. Jack tunes in to make sure I'm not goofing on his solos.
What?
I'm kidding. I said Jack tunes in to make sure I'm not goofing on his solos. You got some solos tonight, Jack. So low you can't hear it. Ow! Where's my...
Oh, God. No, Steve's
what?
Doing something different tonight.
Steve what?
You're doing something right, different tonight.
Really, what?
You're playing a whole show.
I have a whole show.
From one club in one night.
And she remembers this club. I don't.
I remember. We went there once.
And where
and
was it?
It was this night.
Where was it?
Huntington.
Huntington, Long Island?
Yes.
Has anybody been to Sparks in Huntington, Long Island?
I bet Sue has. Sue, I think, is from around there.
Well, that would then Sparks.
Yep.
And I don't remember not one thing about this gig.
I remember several.
Do you really?
I told you the things I remember.
Oh, well, okay. I thought you remembered stuff other than that. I was going to say it was a big night for you.
Oh, I don't see Kitty in the house. Where's Kitty?
Uh-oh.
Is our Kitty lost? Kitty, here, Kitty.
Is she lost?
She's not here.
Say it's not so.
Oh, well, I was going to say, Kitty, don't be upset if you don't see Nippy or Zippy.
Why?
Because you're using
But you know, anyway, the show, the what I'm going to play for you is one continuous show, but there's a lot of dead air, shall we say. So I'm going to kind of try to skip through some of it so that we can.
It's a rat race show.
Yes.
Wow. If you've ever been to one, there was a lot of dead air sometimes.
Yeah, that used to drive me nuts.
Me too.
That drives me nuts with anybody. It drives me nuts with Vernon Kelton. It always, you know, whatever.
They played one gig.
It still drove me nuts. You know, listen, better than you driving.
And we had a very nice anniversary.
Great anniversary. Yeah, I mean, they started taking the pre-orders for the album. It was a weird anniversary because a lot of great stuff happened that had nothing to do with our anniversary, which Except for that cake, yeah.
That cake was amazing.
Oh, you didn't like the ice cream?
I like the ice cream. I love white chocolate and raspberries.
What about, what was, yeah.
And the chocolate covered strawberries. Ooh, sounds romantic.
Doesn't it? What else happened? Don't tell us. well, so, are you making your embarrassed face?
No.
Yeah, you are. Okay. Anyway, so yeah, this is a horrible video. You're going to feel like you're really there. No, I'm serious. You are. This is like, the place is packed wall to wall.
We don't know who took the video. And
I'm not sure who took the video, but I think they were wearing the camera on their head.
Oh, is it going to give me vertigo?
Well, it's not going to give you the winner of the next
race. You didn't tell me it was going to be
No, it's not that. It's just it's a little weird. It's like foggy in the beginning. I've played some of this stuff before, but never in order. So I digitized the whole thing from end to end, including the encore, which is like...
Yeah.
So, it's somebody's lawyer. Somebody's legal guy calling to shut me down.
I don't think so. Okay, shall we?
Okay, yes, we shall.
Get on with the show?
Here we go.
Okay. Ready.
Jack, that's you. Talk about cinematography, huh? Is this amazing or what? There you go, Pee-wee. Now you're focusing. The band's around here somewhere. Okay, I'll give you a hint. Follow the light! Smoke bombs. These were not smoke bombs. This is called a pack club. and a maniac. Oh, that's not smoke. That's, I think that's condensation on the lens. I don't know if you feel that this really was bad. Yeah. You know when you blow your breath on the lens and then you bring it off, they just buzz it out. Clear up soon, I promise. I think. When it clears up, but I think it's pretty soon. I remember her. It's clear enough. It's clear enough. I think the guy had autofocus on and he was zooming in on the back of that guy's head.
Thank you. Thank you.
So yeah.
All right.
So I don't know what it is, but some of this expert camera work is just.
How do you feel now, Steve?
Well, I feel a little ripped off because I didn't know we were supposed to get any of that money.
Well,
I had insurance.
91. 1991, October 19th, if I'm not mistaken.
It's good to see all of you back here.
At what was it? Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, now.
Yeah, but I've never really watched the whole thing.
Yeah, watch this, because Jack is going to do this. Actually, just drop the line for this one song.
It looks like it's Dean. It's Dean.
On the keyboards, Jack Hotop.
Gotta leave this part.
The Reverend, yes. Leaving for Japan any day now. On the drums, way back there behind the golden set, Steve Longo on the drum.
See, focus. Thank you, focus.
The lead vocals and the bass guitar, none other than our very own Dave Canella.
Yeah, well, wait till you hear this. Improvisational music. Improvisational? I'm not sure what's going on here. I don't think anybody else is either. Oh, this could be the blues.
Thank you.
So, we're going to stop right there. Stop right there!
Yeah, because this show is so long.
Before you go any further.
We'll have to do part two next Monday, the second half of the show. It must be Angus.
There it is.
There it is. How are you?
I'm doing good. So, sounds like Southern Cross had a great reunion yesterday.
Yes, give us the update, man. I was gonna shout out, but give me the 411, dude. We were thinking about them all, you know, the whole day.
Yeah, I was too. And I'm sitting there, I text Mousy a couple of times. I'm like, I probably shouldn't bother her, you know. But Tiny said there was about 600 people there. There's a ton of pictures on Facebook of it, you know, from it and everything. And a few videos. It sounded really good. You know, it looks like they had a really great crowd.
Well, we'll have to do a follow-up with those guys.
Yeah, we should. It seems like they all had a real, real good time.
That would be fun.
George.
That would be fun, yeah.
But I wish I could have gone. I really do. I wish I could have gone. I would have loved to have seen that. But,
I wish I could have done the other thing. But listen, careful what you wish for. Are we playing golf now?
Yeah.
No, I've had this hat for a little while. I wore it before, I think, on the show. I like this hat.
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
Mousy said at least 500 people.
That's great.
All right.
No, that's good. So I guess Mousy's what? Yeah. Sorry, Mousy. I didn't mean to bug you by texting you yesterday. But she must have been going nuts. But okay, are we ready for this week now?
I hope we are. Apparently, Remy's not ready for it. But we're ready for it. Of course, we're ready for it.
Remy's trying to leave the building. Okay, this is. I think this is going to be a real good guest tomorrow.
Really?
Now, I'm sure you haven't even thought of this one before. But you know how Lenny, our good buddy Lenny, does that radio program on Friday mornings down in Antigua?
Tiga.
Tiga. This is Zoe Carl. She's the DJ.
Oh, excellent.
She's the DJ down there. So... she's British. In fact, you know what? Let me read her a little short bio.
Yeah, absolutely.
That she's in. It says, all right, Zoe Carlton is living the dream in Antigua. She swapped sharp suits and stilettos for shorts and t-shirts. And instead of snoozing during business meetings, now plays rock music and talks for a living. Antigua and Barbuda West Indies are shocked to have a DJ hitting them with Led Zeppelin instead of Bob Marley. Now the island rocks. Huh?
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'd like to listen to her show. She's on tomorrow?
Yeah, she's on tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, but no, not her show. Her show, he said, was on Fridays.
I think she's on every morning, but Lenny does the show with her on Friday mornings.
In unison.
I think that's what it is. I think I got it straight. Well, she'll straighten me out tomorrow.
It'll be great. Listen, I'll look forward to that. Don't steer me off on the wrong track. She's British, like real British, or
yes.
Really Australian, or from New Zealand?
No, real British. Real British.
Okay.
So... yeah, accent and all. She's a lot of fun.
I don't want to say to somebody, you know. So, never mind. I've done enough. You know, I was on the phone with England day before yesterday, and we'll probably be again tomorrow. And that whole Queen thing.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't. I remember when. I was touring with Leslie when Princess Diana was killed. We were in Vermont, and shortly after that, we went to do the tour of England and whatever else we did right after that, and we saw the flowers. You know how they lay the flowers out? I've seen it since, but I've never seen it before that, and it was mind-boggling. The smell and the layers and layers of colored cellophane and beautiful flowers, unbelievable. Wow. And you know, and I really, especially if she's British from, you know, the Commonwealth or whatever, I want to make sure that I show her some respect, you know.
Yeah. Oh, sure.
I've insulted enough of my friends in the UK.
Okay, do we need to go through the whole week with everybody?
I don't think so, because then we'd have to tell them that our, you know who our Throwback Thursday show is?
I don't know who is.
Ha! Oh, well,
no,
here,
I
switch.
Play the music in that way.
Switch. All
hand.
Right, I'll play the theme song. I'll give you a hint.
Oh. Oh, really?
Yes, the first time you were on.
Yes.
Oh, man. Okay. All right.
I can't wait. I am so looking forward to this. You have no idea.
I'm sure
Thursday's going to be my favorite day.
Don't you have a birthday coming up?
Yeah. That's
the 21st.
Yeah, I know. Well, I gotta jump to the Free for All Friday because there's a new face.
Oh,
we gotta add a new face on it. So let's see if you can find who it is.
Oh.
Oh, thanks, Char. Got some stars.
Oh yes, indeedy, deedy.
Jeff Seitz.
Jeff is there.
Yes, Tiny.
Tiny. Oh yeah, Tiny.
We threw Tiny in there, so.
Very nice. We're getting quite a club.
How can you throw Tiny and not Sunny?
Yeah.
Well, I can only do one a week.
There's a method to it.
Okay.
I can only do one. There's other people I need to throw in there. But I got plenty of weeks left. Okay. I don't have a long joke for you, but I have a few short ones. Okay. You ready for this?
Yep.
And some of them are not. They're jokes. But anyway, okay. Today at the bank, an old lady asked me to help her with her balance. So I pushed her over.
I'll wait. Okay. Here. Okay. Try the veal.
Okay. The other day, my wife asked me to pass her the lipstick. By accident, I passed her the glue stick. Still hasn't talked to me.
Oh.
That's good.
That's
like
all
that.
Right. That's okay.
This one I really like. I couldn't figure out why the baseball kept on getting larger. Then it hit me.
That's good.
Wow.
All right.
Okay.
More stars for Char.
Yeah, thank you. Yep, man, let me get to my star page, wherever that is.
Okay.
Crazy here. Yeah.
Wow.
Right? I mean, you know, here, look at this.
You got it.
Watch me glow. Ready?
Oh, Elvis.
Whoa.
Not Elvis. Angus.
Whoa. Good, right?
Angus.
Yes.
You and Franny have got to watch that Elvis movie.
Oh, man. Oh. You've heard of that guy, right?
On HBO.
Uh-oh. This is not supposed to stop.
Yeah, I'm raising that. The Elvis.
It's called Elvis, in case you forget.
It's new. It's from 2022.
It's awesome.
Yeah,
whatever you think you wished would it might have happened differently in your career.
Yeah.
If you see this movie the way I did, you know.
Okay.
It'll make you happy. If you're happy where you are today, doesn't matter how you got here. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Everything is perfect. It really is. Everything is perfect. And be careful what you wish for.
Yeah.
Oh. All right. All right. I just want to say one more time before I go, about the Southern Cross Boys, all the work they put into this thing, and I'm glad it came off really good for them.
Oh, yeah. So am I. Like I said, we should maybe do a. a night with, if Mousy wants to come in, that would be fun.
Yeah.
And have Tiny, you know, have anybody that wants to come in and do a, you know, do that as a throwback Thursday.
Okay, that sounds good. That's, all right, do you have...
Yeah. Some, a couple of their songs from their show.
Yeah, we could play stuff from this, yeah, from the show.
Oh, that would be a great. You want to do that on a Thursday? You want to do that on a Thursday or a Tuesday?
Oh, Thursday. No, Thursday. We have
Thursday we have.
Angus.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, I forgot. Okay.
Out of that one.
Yeah.
All right. So that is it for me.
Okay, listen, yes. Thanks for coming down and bringing us down with you.
As always.
We love you, bro. And now that your daughter has a boyfriend, we don't see that much of you, and we're trying to figure that out.
Yeah.
Are you like following them around, or what's going on?
No, because they had the football games and stuff like that. I was here this past Friday. I'm good.
Okay. No, you were great. Yeah. Oh, no, listen, you're always great. I just, you know.
Yeah.
Our chats, that's all.
No, I miss being here on Fridays, but I'm back. I'm back all the time. So I got so many new backgrounds. I gotta get rid of the old ones, and I got so much new stuff happening. So
I was thinking about, you know, maybe I would want to be an Artemis, but I'm not sure because nobody's really flown in that thing yet. So I'm happy where I am in the old.
But that's just what I'm there. I actually like this one here, but.
Holy Christmas, there's a lizard crawling on one of our security cameras and it looks like freaking Godzilla.
We got a gecko problem over here. We have geckos.
Gecko problem?
Yeah.
Geckos come out at night.
Yeah, we like those.
Yeah, they're big. They're big.
No,
that's not geckos. That's
iguana.
Iguanas, yeah.
Yeah, I'll send you a picture of one.
Yeah, okay.
It's, if you have a gecko that's that big, you're living with Lenny.
All right, it probably is. All right, guys, I'll see you later.
All right. All right.
Okay. Take care, bro. We'll see you Thursday.
Say hello to the family.
You got it. See you later. All right.
See you, bud. So, okay, so now I have a couple of choices, and I think the choice is clear. Because this was a whole show, this Rat Race thing.
Yeah.
And I think rather than trying to cut a bunch of stuff out,
I'll just play
the other half next Monday.
That's what we'll do, because the Emmys start in 1 minute, and I'm sure that some of our viewers might
not have DVRs.
You know, sometimes you like to be there in real time.
Sometimes things don't go quite the way we planned.
Now, remember, pre-order your John Entwistle
and man,
Rarities Exhumed.
And the first single drops on Friday. I've dropped a lot of shit in my life. A lot of stuff. Glasses, acid. I've never dropped a single. Here it comes.
You've never dropped me.
No, not literally.
No. Remember when you used to have me fly?
I do remember. I was just thinking the same thing. I used to balance her on my legs.
And have me holding out my arms like a little kid and have me fly.
It's fun. Dog used to do that too.
Yeah. It was our version of Dirty Dancing before that movie came out.
That's right. So you could say that, you know, that had nothing to do with us. Anyway, that's going to do it for tonight, I'm guessing.
Tomorrow night, we have DJ from Antigua, Zoe Carlton.
That's going to be, man, I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Because it's different, you know. I mean, I've done some radio on both sides of the mic, actually, and it's not for the faint-hearted.
No.
Because when you're not feeling well and you're not, you know...
You still got to be on.
You got to be on, and there's people listening to you, and you've got to do your thing. Anyway, I'm going to go do my thing. If I don't see you in the future, I'll see you in the pasture.
Good night, everybody.
Take care, kids. Come see Zoe tomorrow, and see ya. We'll be right back.
Thank you.